A joyful noise this morning. Everybody just clap your hands and say, oh, 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 behold he come. Come on, say it. Everybody say it. And the trumpets call. You better lift your voice. Hear of Jubilee. Out of Zion's hymn. Behold he come. Riding on the cloud. Everybody say, and the trumpets come. You better lift your voice. Year of Jubilee. Out of Zion's hill. Whoa. These are the days of Elijah. Preparing the word of the Lord. Oh yeah. And these are the days of his servant Moses, righteousness being restored. These are the days of your harvest. The fields are awry in the world. And we are the laborers in your vineyard, declaring the word of the Lord. Everybody say, come on, say it. Everybody say, and the trumpets call. You better lift your voice. Year of Jubilee. Out of Zion's hill. Oh, these are the days of Elijah. Preparing the word of the Lord. Oh, yeah. And these are the days of his servant Moses, righteousness being restored. These are the days of your harvest. The fields are awry in the world. We are the laborers in your vineyard, declaring the word of the Lord. Everybody say, come on, say it. Everybody say, and the trumpets call. You better lift your voice. Hear of Jubilee. Out of Zion's hill. Before we come. Oh, riding on them. Behold he comes. Everybody say, and the trumpets call. You better lift your voice. Year of Jubilee. Out of Zion's hill. Everybody just clap your hands. Clap, clap, clap. I want you to look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, you might have to slide over some. Because I'm talking about my Savior. Has he made a way for anybody in the room today? If he has, I want y'all to say it like us. There's no God like. Come on, say it. Come on, say it. No, 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 no. There's no God like. Come on, say it. Say it for yourself. No God like. There's no God like. Has he been good to you? Has he bring you through? Has he been through? He reigns forever. No God like. No God like. No God like. Say it. There's no God like you. Come on, say it. Come on, say it. There's no God like. Come on, say it. Come on, say it. Riding on the cloud. Everybody say, and the trumpets come. You better lift your voice. year of Jubilee. Out of Zion's hill.
Amen, amen. Pray about Sister Mo.
Good morning, everybody. Everybody doing good this morning, blessed this morning. Let's bow our heads for a moment of prayer. Oh, gracious, most heavenly Father, we come to you this morning with thanksgiving, honor, and glory on our heart. Heavenly Father, we just thank you for this morning, allowing us to see another day. We thank you for allowing us to rest last night. We thank you, Heavenly Father, just watching over us. Heavenly Father, keeping us, keeping our families, Heavenly Father. And then you woke us up this morning with food on the table, and we can't help but give you all the praise and glory. Heavenly Father, I thank you for my mother, Heavenly Father, who's ill, been suffering for a long time, Heavenly Father. But she knows who's in control, and Heavenly Father, she still give you the praise. Heavenly Father, I just thank you for the sick and the bereaved. Everybody who's gathered here today, I thank you for them, Heavenly Father. We ask that you come into this service. Bless this service. Let it be about you, Heavenly Father. Let us focus on your word, Heavenly Father. We ask that you just bless our pastor as he give us a word this morning, Heavenly Father. Bless the songs that be in song today, Jesus. And Heavenly Father, just go with us. Stand by us. Lead us. Guide us and direct us in the way you would have us to go. We love you, and we can't do anything without you. Amen, amen, amen.
Help us say this.
Your mercy. Thank you.
say that one more time. Somebody know about your mercy.
Your mercy. All the glory, all the glory.
Life down here, you want God to be able to call you on home. Has a mansion laid up for you. Got a crown laid up for you. Anybody gonna talk to me here today? Did we come to have church today, or did y'all come to look at us? We just up here to lead y'all. We want y'all to join in and help us. This is an old song. You might be familiar, might not, but catch on to it after a while, but name of the song is Here, Welcome Me.
Oh, I'm living in light.
God Almighty. Yeah, like the thief in the night. That's the day that he'll come. Me. Oh, 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 I shall see him for myself. Really should be in the air. After the day that Christ arrived, we that are still alive. Won't be long. You look for me. I've gone on home. Yeah, welcome. Yeah. I mean, I want to hear him say, welcome. I'm getting my house in honor today. You've been faithful of a few things. That's what he's going to tell me. Well, when he called my name. One of these days, one of these days, got to be ready, got to be ready, I got to be ready, anybody wanna be ready, anybody wanna be ready, anybody wanna be ready, got to go back to Jesus, anybody wanna go to Jesus, oh, welcome, oh, welcome. Come on, put your hands together, help us say, whoa, welcome. You've been faithful of a few things. Yeah, come on, clap. Come on, clap. Come on, clap your hand. Come on, clap your hand. Come on, clap your hand. Clap it like you love Jesus. Clap it like you're born again. Can I get one witness? Jesus! Jesus! Oh, Jesus! Welcome, here, welcome me.
Welcome me home. Oh, yes, Lord. Jesus, he will welcome me home. Oh, good morning. Good morning, my blessed. Oh, good morning, my blessed. Okay, now, I thought we come to worship God on today.
Yes, sir.
Oh, he's worthy of all our praise. Woo, hallelujah. We want to give the praise team a thank you on that right there. Paying us and getting us to come into the presence of God. So as we come into his presence to worship him, let us just close our eyes and just, I just want you to meditate on the goodness of the Lord.
Yes, sir.
Think about that time when God just brought you through. Think about when your back was against the wall and there was no one else there to call on. Think about when you're laying there late at night and you couldn't figure out how you were going to get out that mess you was in. Think about that time you landed on your sick bed and there was no one there to comfort you or talk to you. Think about when the bills were due and the money was short there. Think about when you felt all alone and you just needed someone to comfort your weeping eyes, your sorrowful heart, your mind that was troubled, your spirit that was all in chaos. My God. Your God, my Savior, your Savior, the healer, the deliverer, the redeemer, the one that came and sealed about us in the midnight hour. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, God. And so as we come on this morning, Father, we just want to acknowledge you as being the creator of the heaven and the maker of all things, the true and living God. And as we enter into your presence on this morning, God, we just want to give you a heartfelt thank you. Oh, with everything within us, we want to say thank you, Jesus, for loving us, keeping us, and blessing us, and healing us, and delivering us. We thank you on today, God, that you allow us to see this beautiful sunshine, God. We thank you, God, that the food we was able to eat this morning. We thank you for the water we was able to drink, God. But most of all, God, we thank you for the Savior, our healing deliverer, Redeemer, Jesus. And so as we enter into your presence on this morning, God, we pray that your spirit now will rest, rule, and abide in each one of us now, God. Father, for all that things that got us burdened and bound down, that got us troubled, we cast it upon you right now, God. Because you said in your word, if we come unto you, you'll give us rest. All the labor and heavy laden, you said, cast it upon you, God. Because you said you care for us. And so, Father, we come this morning casting all our cares upon you, God. I don't know what it is. I don't know what they're going through, but I know you know, God. Because you all knowing and all seeing. And God, I'm so grateful because you are all powerful and you can do all things. And so I thank you on today, God, that you allowed us to come into your house of worship, God, to bow down and worship you now. So this morning, God, we worship you in right here. Holy Spirit, come on in. You're welcome. Have your way in this place on today, God, because we realize you are that heavenly Father, our daddy, that we made true to thank you on today. And Lord God, we thank you for all the fathers on today. We pray for a special blessing upon them, that you'll watch over and keep them, strengthen them, enlighten them, reveal them the purpose and the plan and your promise you have for them, God. Meet every need they have, God, and help them be in that rock that they may be to their family, God. Bless over their wives and their children now. Continue to keep them now, Lord. Bless the family on today, God. Oh, that we may glorify you in all that we do, God. And Lord God, we pray that you'll be in the midst of this service now, God. Help us right now, God, to truly worship you, God. The light prospect before you now. And call out to your name, God, because we love you so. And we realize, Father God, you loved us back. You have loved us with everlasting love. Even when we was in our mess and we couldn't even love ourselves, you still loved us. And so, God, we give you thanks on today. We thank you for the man of God that you have sent here to lead us and guide us. Continue to anoint him. Continue to fill him with your spirit. Enlighten him now with the heavenly vision and the earthly mission you have given him at Mount Pleasant, God. Order his steps in your word, Father God. Give him a right now word because your people come hungering and thirsting for you, God. So bless him now, Father. Use him for your glory. We pray for his family, his wife, and children now. Continue to meet every need they have, God. And Lord God, help us love one another, God. Help us walk in unity together, God, that we may truly be about your business, Father. Making disciples, advancing your kingdom now, God. Help us be about restoring lives, reclaiming souls right now, Father God. Responding to the call, and we rejoice together in you, Lord. So bless this worship service on today. In the precious name of Jesus, we do pray. Amen. 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 Articles of Faith. Number 8, Articles of Faith. That is repentance and faith. Repentance and faith. Is that the back of your hymnal? Over there? Amen. As we read this together, we believe the scripture teaches that repentance and faith are sacred duties and also incessant grace wrought in our soul by the regenerated Spirit of God, while by being deeply convinced of our guilt, danger, and helplessness, and of the way of salvation by Christ, return to God with unfeigned contrition, confession, and supplication for mercy, at the same time heartily receiving the Lord Jesus Christ as our prophet, priest, and king, relying on him alone as the only and all-sufficient Savior. Amen. All right, before you sit down, turn into your program, Mission of Mount Pleasant. Mm-hmm. Mission of Mount Pleasant. It's in your program. Yeah, it's in your program. There you go. Should know about heart by now, no? Amen. 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 Mission of Mount Pleasant. It is the mission of Mount Pleasant Missionary Baptist Church to make disciples to advance God's kingdom by reclaiming souls, restoring lives, responding to God's call, and rejoicing in the Lord together. All right, let's rejoice in the Lord together now. Fellowship time. Go hug somebody. Tell them you love them now. Oh, that's what unity is about. We grow together.
Your name, cause I need you. I'm calling. I'm calling your name, cause I need you. I'm calling your name, cause I need you, Lord. Well, sometimes I get tired and sometimes I get weak. That's why I'm, cause I need you. I'm calling your name, cause I need you, Lord. I'm calling your name, cause I need you. Well, sometimes I get tired and sometimes I get weak. That's why I'm, cause I need you, Lord. Well, I'm praying this prayer right now, cause I need you, Lord. I'm praying this prayer right now, cause I need you, Lord. Well, sometimes my way gets hard and sometimes my way gets dark. That's why I'm, cause I need you, Lord. Well, I'm singing this song right now, cause I need you, Lord. That's right, I'm singing this song right now, cause I need you, Lord. Well, sometimes the road is dark and sometimes the way is dark. That's why I'm, cause I need you. Put your hands together. Anybody love the Lord? Well, sometimes it's hard, and sometimes the way gets dark. That's why I'm, cause I need you right now. I need you, Lord. Need you to hold me in the palm of your hand. Sometimes it gets hard, Lord. I need you to hold me. I need you to rock me in the cradle of your arm. Sometimes I get tired, sometimes I get weak. I need you to hold me in the palm of your hand. I need you, Lord. Well, sometimes I get tired and sometimes I get weak. That's why I'm caught. 'Cause I need you, Lord. I said he woke me up this morning. See what the Lord. I said he woke me up this morning. See what the Lord. I said he woke me up. See what the Lord. So why don't you just count your. See what the Lord. You know he gave me food to eat. See what the Lord. I said he gave me. See what the Lord. I said he gave me. See what the Lord. So why don't you just count? See what the Lord. You know he healed this body of mine. See what the Lord. I said he healed this body. See what the Lord. I said he healed. The Lord, so why don't you just count? See where the Lord. I know there ought to be somebody out there that the Lord has been good to. You don't have to be ashamed, just stand up on your feet. And put your hands together. I gotta tell him thank you. I gotta tell him thank you. I thank you for the roof, Lord, up over my head. I just wanna thank you for food you give me to eat. I just want to thank you for water to drink. You've been good, so, so good. You've been good, yes, you have. You made a way out of no way, and I just wanna thank you. I wanna thank you. I got to tell you thank you. see what the Lord has done. See for the Lord. You ought to count your. See what the Lord.
Well, y'all to count your minutes, blessing. When you start to count your blessing, you can't help but to give God praise. You know, sometimes I start thanking God for all that he done for me, brought me through. It seems like thank you just ain't enough to tell God all that he done for me. So I can't understand why we're sitting here like God ain't never done nothing for us in this place on today. Wow. My God, he said, let's count your minute blessing. Too many times we be looking at what we don't have and start looking at what we do have, we'll realize how blessed we are. Ooh, all right. Hallelujah. Thank you, Mayor Kors, for that selection there. As we continue to move forward the program, we pray and trust that you continue to pray with us, that we get into the presence of God on this morning. Recognition, I guess we have our brother Tommy Clark. Announcement, we're going to have Deacon Michael Berry. A poem by brother Dex Hammond. And pass the observation in that order, please.
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
First, I'd like to give God all praise for this wonderful day on Father's Day.
Amen. Yes, sir.
And I would like to give God praise for making it possible for all the fathers to be here on this day. Do we have any guests? If we do, please stand and give us your name or whatever. And let us know a little something about yourself. Okay, I see everybody's family today. On the behalf of our pastor and minister and deacons, we would like to welcome you and please feel free to come to our church at any time. Our doors are always open. You are always welcome.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Unknown, sick, and shut in. Sister Christine Martin. Sister Ruth Mills, Deacon Joseph Snow, Sister Helen McCord, Brother Gregory Poindexter, Sister Murtis Curry, Sister Lulu West, Sister Willie Mae Cummins, and Sister Nellie Shaw. Announcements. The Sanctuary Choir will practice Saturday, June 21st at 9 a.m. VBS will begin tomorrow, which is Monday, June the 16th, through Thursday, June 19th, from 5:45 p.m. until 8:30 p.m. The closing ceremonies will be held Friday night at 6 p.m. All members are encouraged to participate, and we ask that you will bring your friends with you also. A praise and worship workshop will be held on Saturday, June 21st, from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. here at the church. The youth ministry will be celebrating their anniversary on Sunday, June 22nd at 2:30 p.m. Reverend Durbin Jackson will deliver the message. Prayer for the youth revival will be held Monday, June 23rd and Tuesday, June 24th from 6:30 p.m. through 7 p.m. A youth lecture will be held on Wednesday, June 25th at 6:30 p.m. and an ice cream social will be held immediately following. Youth Revival will be held Wednesday, June 25th through Friday, June 27th at 7 p.m. Minister Cordero Foster of the St. Galilee Baptist Church in Sparta, Georgia will be the revivalist. The youth ministry will swim and fellowship at the White Oak Campground on Sunday, June 29th from 6 p.m. until 9 p.m. Please sign up in the vestibule if you plan to attend. Any member who joined Mount Pleasant between January 2014 through May 2014 is asked to stay after service on Sunday, June 29th to take a picture. For more information, see Sister Reynolds or Sister Cobb. The deaconesses in charge of baptism and communion for the month of June are Sister Anita Cummings and Sister Sandra Roberts. Thought for the week. Good fathers reflect the Heavenly Father. Scripture of the year, Philippians 4:13. I can do all things through Christ, which strengthens me. The prayer warriors will also be in the male Sunday school room after service for anyone who needs prayer. To Mount Pleasant Missionary Baptist Church, from the family of Cheryl Hamilton Lucas. Thank you, Mount Pleasant family, for your prayers, cards, calls, flowers, food, and gifts. It was and is greatly appreciated. Pumpkin will be greatly missed by our family, and we ask for your continued prayers as we move forward. Thank you again, prayerfully, the family of Cheryl Pumpkin Lewis. Lucas, that is. Dear members of Mount Pleasant, you're terrific. I'll never forget you. Love always, Talia D. Clanton. And those are the announcements for this morning. Thank you.
Father, which in heaven, Father, we ask that you guide my words, that this may not be about me, but as it is always about you. In your name we pray, amen.
Amen.
First of all, I'll give honor to God, Lord, and Savior Jesus Christ, to my pastor, pulpit, to members, visitors, and friends. It's this tribute, a little paper out here, a little tribute that I'm going to attempt to do today is about fathers. You know, oftentimes we look upon these holidays. If we go back just a few holidays ago, we had Mother's Day.
Right.
When we look at Mother's Day, they go to the jewelry stores, they buy flowers, they go all out.
For real, though.
But it's Father's Day. We go to Walmart, we go to Family Dollar, we go to Dollar General. I'm just being real this morning. See, one thing about fathers, that's what we do. We get put to the side because that's who we are. You know, we're sort of like on a football team, you got the quarterback. Everybody wants to be the quarterback. Quarterback gets all the glory. But we're like the offensive line. We do the protection. We protect the quarterback. We protect the kids and we protect the family from any harm or any danger that comes upon us. And also, we as fathers, we are the providers. Fathers teach us that a man does whatever he has to do to take care of his family, to take care of his kids. Just because we're hurting a little bit, that don't mean we stay at home. Just because we feel a little bad, that don't mean we stay at home. We do what we have to do. Fathers also teaches us that we must take the high road, that we may not take the easy way out, but we must do things the right way. Father also teaches us about prayer. If you have a praying father, you really have something. Father teaches us that we can do all things through Christ which strengthens us. Father, he also teaches us. I remember my grandfather used to always teach us about amazing grace, how sweet the sound to save a wretch like me. They also teaches us about a charge to keep I have, a God to glorify. They also teaches us, Father, I stretch my hand to thee, no other help I know. You know, one thing about fathers, that's where it all starts and that's where it all ends. On this day, we celebrate you, not just today, but on each and every day. It's your day. In Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen. Thank you.
Amen, amen. We are blessed with some awesome men up in Mount Pleasant. May not say a whole lot, but when we do speak, amen. You see the giftedness that is within. Hello, everybody. Y'all doing all right? Well, happy Father's Day to all the fathers that are in the place on today. And I pray that you realize how special and unique you really are and how valuable you are. We want to welcome all of our visitors that are here on today that have come to celebrate with us. We thank you for coming. Because of you and you being here today, our worship service is that much more better because of your presence. And anytime you want to come, come on to the Pleasant Mount and worship God with us, because all we want to do is experience the goodness of God and feel his presence in this place. If VBS starts tomorrow, ain't that good news? I want to encourage you to bring somebody, I was talking with a couple of members the other day, and I believe it was Sister Lainey Kendrick, and she brought, who was that you brought when they were a little boy? Ricardo Terman. Yeah, brought Ricardo up in here, and he got introduced to Mount Pleasant through VBS when he was a little boy, and he's still here today. Right. Amen. And I've heard of others that have brought children, and they ended up joining and are still here today. You never know whose life may be saved all because you brought them to VBS. Amen. And so I encourage you to bring somebody who does not know the Lord, and pray for them that we'll, one, yeah, have a good time, have some good food, have some good fellowship, but learn who God is. And that's what's most important. So let's come next week and enjoy the goodness of God and the fellowship of one another. On yesterday, man, we had a time in our deacon and trustee workshop. Reverend Andrews came and taught us something, and it was straight in line with what God has been talking to us about the last couple of months. And we are truly excited. And the next time we have a deacon and trustee workshop, we're going to invite all the leaders to come to that. The whole church should have been here to hear all that. It's some good stuff. And we are better all because of that. So I thank the deacons and trustees for making this happen. And we are already better because of yesterday. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Those of you that are still interested in doing the oratorical contest that's sponsored by the Congress of Christian Education, see Sister Connie Moss on today so you can get your packet. And also on June 24th, they're going to have the elimination round for the oratorical contest. So if you're interested, please see her. Also, any student that has not turned in their report cards can still turn them in to Sister Connie Moss by tomorrow at VBS. If you have not turned in the report cards for your students, please, tomorrow by VBS, we need those. Amen?
Amen.
And we need to be in prayer for our service members and for our country. I was informed on today that our dear sister, Courtney Franklin, her mother came and told me that the George H. Bush, that's the the ship that she's on, is headed to the Persian Gulf to prepare for possible war. You see all the stuff that is going on, and we have others who are members that we need to be in prayer for that are in the service, and any family members. And so let us be cognizant of the fact that our freedom costs, and it's not free. Even our freedom in Christ cost us Jesus' life. And so let us join her and the family, she's part of our family, in prayer for their safe return and for God to do something so we won't have to go that route. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. And we are here today only because of the goodness of God.
Amen.
And y'all look so good and so prosperous.
All right.
And I'm going to stop talking and get out of y'all way.
All right, God.
Because I know y'all can't wait to stretch your legs and lighten the load that's in your pocket, in your wallets.
That's right,
That heavy load that you've been bearing. And bring it to God, because God is just good.
Amen.
Bringing it to God. Because God first gave it to us. And we realize how good God is, how he meets our every need. And our faithfulness, listen, is not seen in our church attendance. Our love for God is not seen in our shouts or our hallelujahs. But it's seen in our obedience to God. And when we bring our tithe and offering to God, we're truly showing God that we trust him. For we love our money. We don't want nobody to mess with our money. But if that money is that valuable to you, and you realize that God is the source of everything, and that he'll meet all of your needs, then you ought to come rejoicing and happy, because God has met your needs and gave you a little something that you can bring and give back to him. So this is a way of saying, thank you, God. I love you, God, and I trust you. So we pray now that as you prepare to bring an offering to God, as the minister comes to pray over us, that the Holy Spirit will lead you and guide you into giving back to God what is due him. Amen.
Brother Marfus and Brother Kahn, come on up front for us. Let us all please stand. Bow your heads in prayer. Heavenly Father, we come now. This is one, again, at this appointed time of the service, God, where we truly can genuinely show our love for you, God. Our trust in you, Father, to meet every need that we have, God. And so, Father, as we come now, you told us in the word to be a cheerful giver, God. And so we come now with a cheerful heart, God. Realize you said you'll supply every need that we have, God. And we trust you now to do that, Father, because you have done it down through the years, God. And so, Father, we pray that your blessing be upon this offering and tithe that we take up in your name, God. Bless it right now, increase and multiply, that we may truly do your mission, God, and to build your kingdom, God. We pray for each household right now, every husband, every wife, every marriage right now, every home, every single parent now, God. Bless and meet every need, God, and bless the children. Now, watch over them now, Lord. Now, Father, as we come before you now, we just ask that your spirit will dwell amongst us right now, that we truly give this unto you in your name, that it be as worship experience once again, God. We bless your name and we love you. It's in your son Jesus' name we do pray. Amen.
Amen.
I'm gonna hide behind the mountain. I'm gonna hide behind the mountain. I'm going with it till it don't blow. I'm gonna hide behind the mountain. I'm gonna hide behind the mountain. I'm gonna hide behind the mountain. I know that Jesus is the mountain. I know that Jesus is the mountain. I know that Jesus is the mountain. Hide behind the mountain. out behind the mountain. I'm going where the chilly wind don't blow. Chilly wind don't blow. I'm going well. I'm going well. Will you meet me there? I'm gonna hide behind the mountain. I'm gonna hide. Behind the mountain, I'm gonna hide behind the mountain. I'm going where the chilly wind, chilly wind.
Come forward.
But I'm still here.
Bring your fathers.
And
I want the fathers in front. All fathers up front. All fathers up front. With your children around. All fathers up front, surrounded by your children.
I made it, yeah. Made it through.
All children, get with your fathers. Come on up. Come on up. Children and fathers.
Lied on. Many times I've been lied on. But I'm still here. Burdens. I had to bear so many burdens. But I'm still here. Dark days, I've had my share of dark days, but I'm still here.
And if you're here today and your father's not here, but you see one that you look to as a father figure, why don't you come around them as well? Someone who's a father figure to you. Yours may not be here,
but I'm still here.
But if you look up to him like a father, then I want you to come around them. It's all right. It's all right, grown folk need fathers too. Let us pray. God, our Father, today we have come gathered together, lifting our hearts, our souls, and our minds to you. For we know of no other place to go in the time of need. All of us have had our share of heartaches, our share of bruises, but we are still here. Not because of who we are, but only because of your grace and your mercy. Father God, we need you on today. We've traveled down a road that has been hard to bear. Sometimes making the right decisions and sometimes making the wrong ones. But we are so grateful that you can look past our faults and see our needs. So we ask that you will meet our needs on today. Because God, we realize we're not strong enough, we're not wise enough to handle life on our own. And so we look to you, our Heavenly Father, our all provider and sustainer, asking God that you will meet our needs on today. And I pray right now for the fathers who stand before you, God, that you would meet their needs on today. Though they are men, God, they still hurt and they still cry. Though we are men, God, we still need you. We may be strong, but we're not strong enough in this life to make it without you. God, we may have some sense, God, but we need your wisdom to guide us through the day. God, we are to be a provider for our families. But God, we can only provide when you provide for us. So God, provide us what we need to provide your families with what they need. Heal us, God, where we are broken, God. And lift us up where we are weak, God. Help us, Lord God, to love your children and to raise your children, God. And help us in our weaknesses, God, and in our shortcomings, God, that we may raise up children that will know you and be able to call you Father. We pray, God, for the ones whose fathers are not here, the ones that are gone, and the ones who have never been here. We pray for them, God, that they'll realize that they do have a Father in heaven, who sees and watches over their every move. Let them know, God, that they are no less than those who have a Father, because you are the Father of all people. And so, God, be with them and help them and heal them where they're hurt and where they're broken from not having a Father in their life. And let them know if they will look to the hills from which all their help come from, that you will help them in every situation of their life. Let them know, Lord God, that they are not fatherless, but you are the Father of all people. But most of all, God, be in this service. Fix us where we're broken. Touch us where we need to be touched. Reach those places that nobody can touch but you. Hold us, God, and love us in your arms. And keep our mind stayed on you. We thank you for the fathers that are in our lives. And we ask that you will continue to strengthen them as we walk together on this life's journey. And it's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Of God, that I'm still here today. He was always there
matter what came my way, the very present help in my time of need. Standing right there just to see about me.
It's all good. know better. It's all but I know better.
And I know that it's all. You know, the Bible says in Psalm 27 and 13, David said, I had fainted lest I had believed to see the goodness of God in the land of the living. And what we come to understand and know that even when it doesn't look good, it works for the good. To all those that are called according to his purpose, help us say, it's all God. Everything going on in my life, and it's all God. Had a few hills to climb. Whoa, I don't know that if it is tonight, but I know it's all God. I've had people to lead me, yeah. Whoa, anybody know? Anybody knows? Oh, say that it's all good. Say it, it's all good. No matter what I gotta say, no matter what I'm going through, I know it's all good. Whatever it is, see, even though I walk through the battle, I know the family is good. Friends walk away from me. Whoa, whoa.
I
say, but I know better now. I really do know better now. No, 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 no. Oh,
you have been keeping us down through the years. The blessings that we have had come from you. And we realize that no matter what we go through in life, all things work together for the good. For them that love God and called according to his purpose. So we thank you for your presence on this day. We ask now that you would speak to our hearts, our souls, and our minds. Holy Spirit, have your way. Is our prayer In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. It's all good. Don't look at your situation. Because if you look at your situation, it won't look good. But when you look at God, then it's all good. Happy Father's Day. Once again, to all the fathers in the house. This used to be a hard day for me. Years ago, I had a daughter but wasn't with her. She lived in another state, and Father's Day would be hard for me. Coupled with that was the reality that my wife and I had lost a son in birth, and that caused pain in our hearts. And so I realized today that there may be some of you here on today. For one reason or another, this may be a hard day for you. And I pray for you on today that God will give you the healing like he gave me. Things still hurt from time to time. But he is a God who is able to heal and give strength. So trust him in your pain and in your hurt. And God will take care of you. Today we want to look in Psalms. Psalms 126, and we're going to look at that in its entirety. Psalms 126. Psalms 126. In its entirety, and I'm coming out of the NIV version. It reads, "When the Lord restored the fortunes of Zion, we were like those who dreamed. Our mouths were filled with laughter, our tongues with songs of joy. Then it was said among the nations, the Lord has done great things for them. The Lord has done great things for us, and we are filled with joy. Restore our fortunes, Lord, like streams of the Negev. Those who sow with tears will reap with songs of joy. Those who go out weeping, carrying seed to sow, will return with songs of joy, carrying sheaves with them." From this psalm, we hear God speak on, let's turn this thing around. Let's turn this thing around. We want to thank God for all of the fathers that are here on today. And the fathers that have been active and very instrumental in our lives. We want to thank the fathers who raise their kids the right way and the best way that they know how to raise them. I salute you, fathers, who have sacrificed to provide for your children, corrected and loved your children. I salute you on today. I salute you, fathers, who have made your children feel safe just by your mere presence. I salute you, fathers, who teach your sons how to be boys and help them mature into manhood. I salute you, fathers, who love and support your daughters and teach them how to look for the right one and teach them what to look out for. I salute you, fathers, who teach your children about God and help them to live a godly and moral life as children as well as adults. Today, we thank God for the fathers in our lives who are here with us now and for our fathers who have gone away. And as we celebrate fathers on today, we must admit that there is a problem. I don't want to take away from our Father's Day today or dampen the mood, but there is a problem in our community, in our society, and in our culture. There is an epidemic. There is a rapid spread or increase in fatherlessness. And it's spreading from one generation to another. And it affects everybody in the community. I was running, doing some research, and I didn't finish, but I was looking at the statistics and how fatherlessness affects the community. It affects it in more ways than we realize. It affects the economic condition of a community. It affects the economic condition of a household. It causes severe depression and anxiety in children. Fatherlessness causes more suicide in the lives of those who are without a father. Fatherlessness causes more crime and drug addictions in families where there is no father present. There is an epidemic of fatherlessness that has been going on for quite some time. But the good news about an epidemic is that an epidemic with the right medicine and the right prescription can be cured. An epidemic is only temporary. But when the right medicine is applied to the epidemic, when the right prescription is wrote and given to help with this epidemic, then a cure can be found and healing can take place. The word father means originator in one sense. But in another sense, it means a man who exercises parental care over other persons. There are a lot of originators, those who have begotten a child. That's just biological. But what we need is a father who is not just biological, but relational, has a close, intimate relationship with their child. Fatherlessness occurs when the father is absent in the life of a child. You can still be present. You can be in the home, but still be absent. If you are not actively involved in the life of your child. Fatherlessness is one reason why it is important for men to be involved and active in the church. Men, your presence in the church makes a difference to those kids who wake up with no father in the home and may not have a mature Christian father to see at home. Then they go to school and they see no males at school. Then they go back to a fatherless home and walk the streets where the streets teach them about what it is to be a man and to be a father. This is what some of our young boys and our young girls experience day after day. And then we expect them to act different than what they have been taught and what they have experienced in life. They experience hurt, pain, and depression that they don't even understand and don't know how to deal with. And it manifests itself in anger, rebellion, and can lead to crime, drugs, and gang activity. Yes, they begin to influence and bully and pressure those who have what they don't have and have what they want and make life hard for those who are trying to live the way their parents have called them to live. They make it hard for the youth who are struggling with right and wrong and searching for the truth in life and their own identity. Fatherlessness affects all of us. Yes, even if you have a mother and father in your home, the fatherlessness of a community and society does touch your home. All of this is a cry for help, and they don't even know it, because they are in survival mode. All right, but it's a cry for help and love that they don't know that they need. But my brothers and sisters, can I tell you that we can turn this thing around? It doesn't have to stay that way.
We don't have to sit back and let it happen. Girls and young ladies need to be taught about what a father is and the importance of a father. I may be getting ready to make some folk mad right about now. But if you call your child's daddy a baby daddy, then you just might be a baby mama. I know there are some exceptions to that, but why do you expect him to commit to your child when he wasn't committed to you? Why do you expect him to pay child support when he didn't have a job when you met him? He was a fool before you met him. He was a fool before you had the child. So after you have the child, he's still gonna be a fool. You said it, not me. Why are you going to get mad because he cheated on you before the child? He cheated with you when he's with somebody else, and now that he's with you, you think you're going to turn that thing around, but it ain't going to happen. If you're mad, I'm sorry that you're mad, but it's the truth. And if we're going to turn this thing around, we have to be confronted with the truth. A brother is not going to change just because you had a child. If anything, it'll make a brother run even further. We have to make better choices. This is the lie that is being perpetuated and supported in our culture and live from one generation to another. And we sit back and just let it happen. Even Christians live the same lifestyle. But before you get mad at me and stop listening, maybe a little too late, but let me tell you, I believed and lived the same lie. Mm-hmm. My daughter suffered from fatherlessness. Though we have a close relationship now, 24 years later, she is still suffering from my wrong and my selfish living. And she's still living with the emotional and financial scars. 24 years of pain, confusion, depression, and wrong relationships because her mother and I, not Sister Lockett, ain't always been a preacher, ain't always been saved. And I still feel the guilt of my ignorance and my selfish choice. But I'm determined, my brothers and sisters, to turn this thing around. This is one reason why God says in Genesis 2:24 that a man shall leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and they shall become one flesh. This is marriage. Genesis 1:28 says, God blessed them and said to them, be fruitful and increase in number. Fill the earth and subdue it. So ladies, as some of you have found out the hard way, that who the father of your child is does matter. If you can't say I do, prove to you that he does and take care of you and a child, then move on. Ladies, we need to talk to the younger ones and let them know of our mistakes so that we won't perpetrate the same thing that has been going on from one generation to another. There are some good things to pass from one generation to another, and there's some bad things to pass from one generation to another. And young ladies and young men, just because we did it, don't make it right. We have to make better choices. Because ladies, if he can't say I do, if he can't commit to you, if he doesn't show you that he is a provider, then you need to let him go. Because that's what's best for you, that's what's best for him, and that's what's best for the child who may come out of that relationship. Well, ladies, we must turn this thing around. There are men who were fatherless, and now you are a father. And some plan to be a father one day. But let's turn this thing around. Don't become a father until you're ready to take care of yourself and your wife in holy matrimony first. There was another place I was going to go, but I'm going to save it for another time. I was going to talk about being thirsty. We get thirsty, but we drink from the wrong well. Jesus says, if any man thirsts, let him come unto me. I say that for later. The Psalms 126 is a song of ascents. It starts off in a low place, and as it progresses to a greater height. The children of Israel were in a low place. They were held captive in a foreign land. That was their low place. But the testimony is that God brought them out of their low place. They testified that God has done great things for them, and this filled them with joy. And now they look forward to the greater things that God was going to bring to their lives. And they prayed that God will continue to restore them. The children of Israel saw and experienced God moving in their low place and taking them from where they are and leading them out of their situation and blessing them and restoring them. And as they saw and experienced the move of God in their lives, it filled them with joy and they began to rejoice. They weren't fully restored yet, but they felt God moving in their lives. They hadn't received everything that they wanted, but they realized that God is good and that God had heard their cry and did not leave them in a low place, but he reached way down to bring them out. And they realized that God was not through with them yet. In other words, God turned that thing around. My brothers and my sisters, though there is an epidemic in the land, if we put our trust in God and live for him and teach one another the values and the morals and the word of God, then God can turn that thing around. When we stop looking at what we want and what we desire and begin to look to God and let God meet all of our needs, then God can turn that thing around. We got to start teaching our children the right way. We got to start hooking up the right way, the way that God has said that man and woman should come together. And when we do it God's way, then God blesses and he can turn that thing around. I don't know about you, but I'm not through with the generation that's coming up right now. I still believe that God can turn this thing around. It ain't got to be like that always. God can turn our young women and turn our young men around. When we begin to pray and seek God's face and ask him to forgive us of our wicked ways, then he'll hear from heaven and heal our land. He'll turn this thing around. I want better for our children and our grandchildren. I want better for our great-grandchildren and those who will come after us. We may have suffered and we may have done wrong, But I believe God can turn this thing around. Verse 5 said, those who sow with tears will reap with songs of joy. The children of Israel cried because they were in a foreign land. And can you see the tears coming down their eyes and wetting up their clothes, because now they don't know what the future may be? Can I let you know that God allowed for the enemy to come and get them? He did that because the children of Israel turned their back on God. They forsook God. And so God allowed for destruction and devastation to happen in their life, because God realized it wasn't until they realized how much they needed God that they'll turn back to God. And my brothers and my sisters, there's an epidemic in the land. And we ought to realize right now that we need the Lord. And we need to cry out to the Lord and believe that He'll hear our cry. So He'll turn this thing around. We got to stop looking at what we want and start living for what God will have us to be. When we do that, we see a change in fatherlessness in the community. And what others meant for our bad, God can turn around for the good. Folk done taught us some stuff in their pain and their misery, and we believed it, and we lived it for years. And what they were doing was they were having us join them in their pain. And they did not mean it for our good, but they meant it for our bad. But when we come to ourselves and realize our wrongdoings and realize the ways of God, and when we taste and see that the Lord is good and we turn ourselves around, then God will turn our situations around. God won't turn our situations around until we turn ourselves around to God. Let me say that again. Until there's repentance, there won't be no blessings. All have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. But that don't mean we got to keep on sinning. Because the Bible said where sin abounds, grace does much more abound. God has enough grace to cover any sin that is in our lives. And when we give our lives over to God, God will start working that thing out. He'll start changing hearts. And He'll start opening doors. And He'll start bringing blessings that we couldn't get on our own. He'll start turning that thing around. You'll see your children making better decisions than we made. You'll see your grandchildren graduating from college and getting good jobs and raising a family. God will start turning that thing around. God is a God who's able to change our situations. But He won't change our situations until we change our mind. When we change our mind and begin to live for God, not just Sunday, but every day, then we'll see a move of God in our life. And you'll look at your life one day and realize that God sure enough is good. Because when you start seeking God, God will start seeking you. When you want God, God will want more of you. And when you want to be in God's presence, God will be in your presence. And when you're in the presence of God, there's peace. When you're in the presence of God, there's power. When you're in the presence of God, there is joy. So even in the midst of our messed up lives, God can turn that thing around. So my brothers and my sisters, on this Father's Day, I pray that God will continue to bless the fathers that are in here on today.
that even though we're doing good, that God will help us do even better. Because just because our children got a father, somebody else's child needs to see a father. The Bible says, God says, I'll be a father to the fatherless. But how is he a father to the fatherless? When those men of God put their trust in God, but not only raise their kids, but they'll look out in the community and they'll look out in the church and they'll begin to speak truth into the lives of the children that they are around. When men of God realize that their fatherhood is not just with their biological children, but they are fathers to the fatherless. That's how God is a father to the fatherless. He uses men who have no children to be a father to a child who needs a father. God works and moves through his church. So when the children come to church, they'll see what a good and Christian father and man should look like. They'll have an opportunity to see something different than they see in the world. And when they get up in here and we go to praying, something will move on the inside of them. It's called the Holy Ghost. And when they get saved, the Holy Ghost will try to hook them up with somebody who knows the Lord. I believe that God will turn this thing around. I know that he can, but it's up to us to live for God. Because I'm tired of seeing so many children hurting, broken, frustrated, on the way to hell. They didn't ask to be here. They didn't ask to be in the situation that they are in. But church, can I tell you something? God has left the church in the world so that when we see situations like that, he can turn that thing around through the church. You hear that? God will turn that thing around, not just out of some special miraculous way, but he uses the church to turn things around. And so my brothers and sisters, my prayer today is that we will allow God to use us to turn that thing around. God bless you. God bless you. We can do it. It's going to take a little work, but can't you see it right now? Can't you see more families being blessed by the power of God? Can't you see your children and your grandchildren being blessed and having homes that are blessed by God? Can't you see right now more fathers in the homes and more fathers in the church? God can do it, but it's up to us to let God turn that thing around. And today you may be here, and you may not have realized that God is your father. You've been living your life by yourself. You've been hurting. You've been in pain. You're frustrated and you're depressed because your life is one that is filled with bad choices. And it's not because you're a bad person. You've been taught to live that way. But on today, God wants you to know that there is a better way. And that there was a man by the name of Jesus who died on Calvary for the sins of the entire world. He died on Calvary early on Sunday morning. God raised him from the grave with all power in his hands. And now if you believe that, you are saved. You are washed with the blood. But what God wants you to do now is be more than just saved. But he wants you to find a church home where you can learn more about God and where God can use you to minister and reach and touch other people. And so today, if you're here and you're not saved, or if you're looking for a church home, the doors of the church open. And if there is one, we ask that you will come. Will you come on today? God, our Heavenly Father, is calling for you. And he's made a way for you that when a life here on earth is over, that you'll have a home with God. God, our eternal and divine Father, he's prepared a place for us that where he is, we will be also. Will you come? Will you come on today? It's okay. You don't have to understand it all. But all you have to do is believe in your heart that God is calling you to himself. Will you come? We're waiting for you. Will you come? No, we wait for you, but God is waiting for you too. God has seen your life and he wants to turn your life around, but he won't do it until you surrender yourself to him. Will you come on today? Yes, he will. He'll make your life brand new. Are you ready on today? God will take care of you. Will you come? Will you come? God is our Heavenly Father. And he wants you to know today that he loves us in spite of who we are. He provides for us every day. And he wants the best for us in life. But he can't give it to us until we give ourselves to him. So my prayer today is that all that are here today are saved. And if you're not and you don't understand, please get with somebody in the church. Get with me and get your questions answered. Because this is serious. This deals with eternity. And I don't want nobody to spend eternity in hell. But I want us to spend eternity with God our Father. And so at the end of this service, if you're not sure, get with one of the ministers, usher, deacon, somebody who knows. If they don't know, they can point you to somebody who knows. Let us pray. Father God, we're grateful for knowing that you are our Father. You are our sustainer, maintainer, and provider. You give us air to breathe every day. You wake us up with brand new mercies. You provide us with something to eat. May not be what we want, but we got what we need. Every day, every step, every breath, every second of the day, you are taking care of us. And for that, we're so grateful to have a father like you. And God, if there's someone here today who is not saved, God, have someone be in their presence to let them know that the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is everlasting life. Put a hedge of protection around them and let them not see death until they accept you as Savior. Lord God, let them know they need to get in a hurry because tomorrow is not promised. And for those fathers that are here today, we pray that you will continue to give them strength and wisdom to lead their family. And for those that are here that have come from a fatherless home, we thank you, God, because by your grace and your mercy, you have kept them. We thank you, God, because they have realized that you are a father to the fatherless. And you provide people there to support, to provide, and take care of them. Yes, you are true to your word. And so, God, we just say thank you. We ask that you would keep moving in our lives and that you would turn things around that are not like you. Help us, Lord God, to surrender ourselves to you. Now may the grace of God and the sweet communion of his Holy Spirit rest, rule, and abide henceforth, now and forever with us, your people. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God bless you.